On this episode of the podcast, we take a look at the movie Dumbo, written by Ehren Kruger, adapted from the novel by Helen Aberson, directed by Tim Burton, starring Colin Farrell, Michael Keaton, Danny DeVito, Ava Green, Nico Parker, Finley Hobbins, and Alan Arkin. Welcome to He Said, She Said Movie Reviews. This is the podcast where a happily married couple with similar but different movie tastes take a quick look at the movies, helping you make the right decision before your next movie. I'm your host, Tim.
And I'm April.
So we got to go see Disney's Dumbo. April gives this movie a 3, and I give it a 3.5. I'll tell you all about it right after these two trailers.
All right. The first trailer we saw was for Aladdin. It looks fantastic. It's about a kind-hearted Arabian street urchin and a power-hungry grand vizier. Right, Tim?
Yeah.
He's vying for a magic lamp that has the power to make the deepest wishes come true. It's with Naomi Scott and Will Smith. All right. The second trailer we saw, which I can't wait to see, The Secret Life of Pets 2. It's continuing the story of Max and his pet friends following their secret lives after their owners leave them for work or school each that day.
I got to tell you, this is one of the previews recently that I sat there and I laughed during the trailer. The Secret Life of Pets 2 looks really funny. I can't wait to see it.
Well, you've got Kevin Hart and Patton Oswalt and many more, and I just think it's going to be hilarious.
Yeah, the pets go to a farm, it looks like, and the dogs, and it just looks hilariously funny.
Those of us who are obsessed with our pets, we're going to love this one just like we did the first one.
Okay, so Dumbo. Everybody knows, or everybody should know the story of Dumbo, but if you don't, it's all about a young elephant whose oversized ears enable him to fly, and he helps save a struggling circus. This was original a Disney film, animated short film, actually, not a full feature-length movie, but a short film that was put out 40 years ago. And in this version, it's directed by Tim Burton, and it's written by Ehren Kruger, who was known for Arlington Road, The Ring 1 and 2, multiple Transformer movies, and Stephen King's The Skeleton Key. And it was adapted from Helen Aberson's novel. So it's got a great cast.
It sure does. Colin Farrell, Michael Keaton, Danny DeVito, Eva Green, Nico Parker, and Alan Arkin.
And a lot of these actors have worked with Tim Burton in the past, some of them up to 4 times. So
yeah, they have. I don't think it's a big secret. I'm not a Tim Burton fan, actually. But I did go and see Dumbo. The runtime was 112 minutes, which it was longer, in my opinion, than it needed to be.
Okay. I thought it could have gone a little bit longer, but there were some slow parts. Also, I really need to point this out, and this is important to you, especially your parents who you think you're going to be taking your kids to. This is not a G-rated movie. This is Tim Burton's version of Dumbo.
True.
Okay,
so
it's rated PG for peril, action, and some thematic elements. And I'll be honest with you, I sat there and I thought, wow, like one of our nieces, she's in her tens now, but I'm telling you, if she was like 8, she would not have been able to handle this movie. She cried at the end of the last Avengers movie. So
yes, she did, and for good reason. I just want to say that, and I'll get it out of the way, there were many things in this movie, in my opinion, that were unnecessary, they're evil. I mean, I'm sorry. You're going to hurt an animal. You're going to get in a fight. There was just tons of things I didn't think were necessary. So I'm not a Pollyanna by any means. But when it comes to a movie for kids, can't we just focus on a happy movie without so much darkness and evil?
Well, once again, this is a Tim Burton movie, April, and it's PG. I don't really think this was a kid's movie.
Yes, that's a very good point.
You know, it's Tim Burton, and it has, if you're familiar with his movies at all, you know what kind of vision he puts into movies. You know the dark elements that he puts in this movie. This movie has some things of nightmares in it.
Right. Let me just say then maybe someone else should have directed it. I wanted to see a movie about Dumbo. I wanted a complete feel-good movie. Okay. And I'm sorry. It just didn't happen.
Okay. So once again, I thought this movie theme, if you believe you can fly, you can fly. Right. I thought the acting was really good. The interesting thing, Michael Keaton's character, V.A. Vanderveer, this was a complete poke at Walt Disney. I mean, it was the evil side of Disney and Disneyland, and it's surprising that Disney did this in a movie.
Yeah, I thought that too.
Even the when they walk into the theme park at the in the third act of the movie or the last part of the movie, it is Disney World. You know it's Disney World, and they call it Dreamland, but it looks and feels like if Disneyland was developed by Tim Burton.
I also want to say, though, that I, of course, love elephants, but this little baby elephant I'm in love with. There are also some things in it that I enjoyed. And I know Tim loved the opening music, too, with the train, the whole score.
You know what I found out about the score when I was putting this stuff together for this movie? This was Danny Elfman.
Academy Award Danny Elfman,
you know, and he's worked with Tim Burton multiple times.
I love Danny Elfman.
And it was great. And it was a Danny Elfman score. Not that opening music, the train going and the maps.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like,
that was neat.
I was neat.
And I also want to say the cinematography, it was just a beautifully shot movie. It was just stunning. Even the night scenes, it was all well done, y'all. The costume, the colors,
all that is what Tim Burton's known for. He's known for the very visually stunning movies.
No. And it was, but again, it would have been really nice to have made that movie without so many things that were dark.
Well, you know, there has to be a reason for Dumbo to fly, April.
Well, okay. Okay, but Dumbo can fly because Dumbo believed he could. And there's even a line in the movie that I really, really loved about keys, not needing a key to unlock the door, which I love. You know, I love all that kind of motivational, not just quotes, but thoughts, themes. That's not it. I love that Dumbo could fly. I love that Dumbo believed in himself to fly. But again, it's a movie that so much of it's right. But the bottom line, do you really need some of those, all that darkness? I'm sorry.
Yeah, you're starting to sound a little bit like a party pooper.
Sorry. Maybe I should have rated it lower.
Maybe you should have. I really enjoyed this movie. I love the fact that they brought a lot of things in from the animated movie, but made them different. Like the whole thing in the animated movie with the storks delivering all the baby animals. They brought the storks in the part of the beginning part of the movie. They had the nightmare pink elephants, but in this case, they made them bubble elephants.
Yeah, I loved that.
Dancing and Danny Elfman's music. And what I really loved about that scene was Dumbo was sitting there dancing along with his head to the music for when the pink elephants.
And a shout out to the costumes. I thought they were fabulous. Number one, and I also loved the love between the mother elephant and the baby. Just the intertwined trunks was just so sweet.
Yeah, and I love the CGI effects on the elephants. And I really do believe after watching that movie that elephants can fly. So
Me too. And again, I gave it a 3. I'm glad Tim gave a fair warning up front. Be very careful about little kids. Watching this movie because there are going to be some things that bother them.
Yeah, I think if you were to take a 6, 7, 8-year-old kid who's a little on the sensitive side, they might have bad dreams after watching this movie.
Yeah, I think that's fair.
I mean, there are some things in here that will give kids nightmares.
Yeah.
No doubt about it.
And a shout out to Danny DeVito. I thought he did a great, great job.
Oh, yeah. I thoroughly enjoyed Danny DeVito. Colin Farrell, I enjoyed his acting in this movie.
Kids did a good job, too, I thought.
I could have given this movie a 4, but I think it slowed down a little bit and the pace got a little bit.
Yes, it did.
And there was one part of the movie where it seemed like there was a hole that they just like skipped over part of the movie. And I don't want to do any kind of spoilers or anything, so I'm not going to, but it just.
Let's don't.
It to me, yeah. The editing might have been off a little bit at that part. It just was me. Oh, and the other thing I really want to put a shout out, and this is the guy thing from the he said, she said part of things. If you're a fight fan and you know who Michael Buffer is, he has a cameo in this movie. And I, when it came out, and I was just like, I started rolling out laughing, and half the people in the theater had no idea who Michael Buffer is. And it was great. It was funny, and it was very appropriate.
Tim loved that.
You know, if you know who I'm talking about, you know what his number one tagline on is, and just change Rumble to Dumbo. And it was hilarious.
All righty. Well, listen, I hope you go to see Dumbo. It was just, you know, I rated it at a 3, but that we've said all we need to say.
Yeah, go see this movie in the theater. Leave your little kids at home, though.
All right, we will see y'all at the movies, and we thank you for all of your support. We are completely humbled and overwhelmed. We're hearing from people all around the world.
We've been getting some great feedback from the listeners, and we really appreciate it. And if you'd love to let us know what you think, please give us send us an email at movies@hesaidshesaidmovies.com, or you can find us on social media. We're on Twitter, we're on Instagram, we're on Facebook. Follow us on Facebook. We'd really appreciate it. Thanks a lot, and we'll see you at the movies.
We'll see you at the movies.